This short chapter I devoted to presentation of the reinforcements made before laying the concrete slab. We have here an overview of different designs, each of which require a slightly different type of reinforcement. They differ in shape and the number of rods contained in beams and slabs. The individual elements of reinforcement were commissioned to the steel company. Those remains, as in the case of foundation, put them in the right places and tie. At this point, we are on the external lintels formwork that we made in the previous chapter. Reinforcement will also be joined with another weird, which will be built under the roof structure. Now you see the setting of the corner pin, built with hooked-shaped rivet rods. Each item is exactly described and dimensioned in a construction project. The arms have 1 meter in length. First we just pre-attach them to the lintel reinforcement. Raised up bars will create the characteristic shape of the corner. After a moment it will be more visible. To bind us in the case of the foundation, we used steel wire and a key-like device. Here you can see a bit better what's the matter. The construction of 2 reinforced concrete beams that will create the corner, which will one of the many pins we'll do to join construction with upper concrete crown. Now we're tying the stirrups, initially only enough to maintain the structure. Afterwards we'll attach several of them at a distance of 20 cm from each other. The same structure we do in every corner of the building. Such a powerful reinforcement arises only in those areas where the floor structure is supported by the outer pillars. These places are extremely strengthening in order to reduce pressure on the poles. And this is primary reason why we will make here a reinforced concrete slab instead of the terriva ceiling. Please note that each from the reinforcement rods are inserted into the lintels and from the side of the building to the reinforcement of the reeds. Reinforcement of the floor slab is performed as a grid, where bars are crossing every 20 cm. We are tied the rods at its intersections. Reinforcement ought to be carried up approximately 5 cm, but not more, because the strengthen should be in the lower part of the concrete slab. The old structure is sufficiently robust that probably removing the structural columns would not make a big difference. Pay attention how it looks here at the rims. Everything is interconnected: deriva floor beams, weirds, slabs and lintels. In order to lift the mesh, we can use ordinary pieces of bricks. It is important that the concrete cover the reinforcement from the bottom about 5 cm. The same job on the other side of the building. You can take a specifically look at the lintels. As I mentioned in the first part, the reinforcement of the ceiling are much more interesting than those one used during the foundation job. Here we see an additional substring which will support one of the corners of the roofing frame. We had to perform it because the major roofing construction must be supported by a reed in the shape of a rectangle, while the front part of the building is extended forward to form an irregular outline. We move now to the reinforcement of balconies. We make them in the same way as we did the slabs. On the front we have a beam which, as you can see, is bent in an arc shape. At the edge of the building and in places where the beams are made, an additional steel mesh made of rubber bars with a diameter of 9 mm have to be laid. Such grids you can buy as ready-produced items. Their distribution depends on the particular construction project. At the end, a quick overview of the all reinforcement. In the background you can see the concrete mixer, and now we will proceed to the laying of concrete, which I will present in the next final chapter of this part of the tutorial.